Good afternoon, Village. Pastor Ron here. Welcome to another episode of Rooted Online, where we're trying to connect with each other and dive into God's Word together. Glad you joined us. Good to see a lot of you online on Sunday and the pictures, and it just warms my heart to see us still striving to be a community that is learning about Christ during this time. Before we jump to 1 Peter, though, I want to mention an idea I'm stealing from Women's Bible Study. It's the 1-1-3 idea that I think will help us as a church connect and stay connected during this time. The idea is that every day we connect with at least one person. That could be email, that could be text, FaceTime, whatever it is, and we pray for at least three people. So one day, one person we connect with, three people we pray for. And if we committed to do that as 200 people at Village, what a difference would that make? So I challenge us to do that. But we want to jump into 1 Peter chapter 1, verses 8 and 9 today. That's what we'll be reading. And Pastor Andrew and Pastor AJ have been talking in the verses prior to this about our ultimate source of hope. It's in heaven, and that we have an inheritance with Jesus Christ that is incorruptible, and nothing can change that. We know who wins, and that gives us ultimate hope. But sometimes we can ask the question, what about now? What do I do at the present time? How do I have hope tomorrow? How do I have hope the next day? How do I get through this? And so Peter, in these two verses, goes to the now. What hope Jesus can bring even right now in the difficult time. Listen to this. Though you have not seen him, you love him. Though you do not now see him, you believe in him and rejoice with joy that is inexpressible and filled with glory, obtaining the outcome of your faith, the salvation of your souls. And Peter begins now by saying, even though you never saw Jesus, and they hadn't walked with Jesus, these churches had come to know him through the testimony of others, but even though you haven't walked with him, even though you haven't seen him, you chose to love him with a deep, ongoing love, and you chose to believe in him. And that word for believe is to trust, to rest in confidence on. And these believers chose to love Jesus and follow Jesus and believe him and trust him, even though they hadn't seen him, even in the middle of difficulties. But then Peter goes on to say what that resulted in by saying, and you rejoice with a joy that is inexpressible and filled with glory. So you've loved Jesus, you believe in him, and now you're able to rejoice with a joy that is inexpressible and filled with glory. A joy that is too much for words. And we see a pattern here that Peter is laying out that says, when we choose to love Jesus in the middle of difficulty, when we choose to trust him in the middle of difficulty, we see him work. We see him sustain us. We see the glory of his hand around us and in our lives. And then that builds more relationship, resulting in joy, not that the circumstances are gone, but the joy is that we know that Christ is present, and we know his present in a whole new way. And so this then becomes a circle where the more that we love Christ, the more that we act in faith and belief and trust in him, the more joy we have as we realize that he's helping us, and then we love him more, and there's more trust, and this circle feeds on itself. I can remember when I go on trips, often Susie will leave me notes, and she'll put notes in my luggage, she'll put notes in my books, in my Bible, and she'll text me notes. And every time I get one of those, even though I'm not with her, it reminds me that she cares. And it reminds me that, in a way, she is with me. That's just a little tiny taste of what it's like, what Peter is talking about, it's like with Jesus. When we love and trust him in the middle of it, in the middle of the storm, we know that he is showing up and helping us, and that is why we can have joy. He goes on in verse 9 to say, for you are receiving the goal of your faith, the salvation of your souls. And what he's referring to is not just the original salvation, but this word is the ongoing salvation where we're being sanctified, we're being changed. We're being changed to be like Jesus. And that's the other aspect of trials, right? As we go through them, as we love and trust God, not only does he give us joy, but he's using it to refine us, to change us. And we should take joy in that. That's exciting that God can use even the difficult times, even the times that are a result of a fallen world, he can use those to change us into Christ-likeness. That's what he's doing for you and I right now. He's changing us as we trust and as we love. So don't worry, don't have anxiety, trust and love our God. And maybe loving him means being in the Word. You can't show that you love Jesus without spending time with him. So make sure you're spending some extra time in the Word. Make sure you're memorizing God's Word. Make sure you're getting fed through videos or some other sources. But make sure you're in God's Word loving Jesus that way. But also maybe take a journal and start to list all of the ways that God's been faithful. In the last 5 years or in the last 5 weeks, how has God been faithful? Because we need to remember what God has done so we can celebrate what he's done. And so take some time to remember the faithfulness of God, to trust God, and to not be anxious, to not worry, but know that God's got this. Village, can't wait till we get together again. God bless.